the jewel of the Riviera. Nothing but champagne from now to the finale. Oh, I see so many old friends and so many new faces. Bonsoir, bonsoir. Monsieur Dame, the inevitable is upon us. Welcome to the 15th edition of our world-famed review, starring the one and only Zaza, and featuring the notorious and dangerous Cajels. Ladies and gentlemen, I warn you to remain in your seats while Les Cajels perform. The management will not be responsible for your safety. And now, I beg you, open your eyes. You have arrived at La Cage au Folle.
Daily.
Bianca Hanna. And now, Phaedra, the Enigma. The riches of the pharaohs, the spices of Siam, the babble of Babylon cannot buy the secret of her fatal charms. Thank you, Phaedra. And now, on with our spectacular extravaganza!
Face life, though it's sometimes sweet and sometimes bitter. Face life with a little guts and lots of glitter.
If I didn't have a wife to support, I would.
Alban! Alban! Your diet pills have arrived from America.
Never mind.
Too late. Too fat.
We have a show to do. Come on, Mercedes. Someone's got to go on.
All right, I'll go on. I'll go on. But I am warning you.
You are warning me what?
I won't be happy. Woo!
Abbott, you know what is going on out here. Open the...
I am ready. You may begin my music.
Just what do you think you're doing in one of Madame Zaza's gowns?
Madame Zaza has been delayed due to technical difficulties. And as Madame is indisposed, I feel it only my duty as her friend, confidant, and personal handmaiden to be certain that the show go on.
An applaudable sentiment, Jucko. But this season we are not featuring butlers in the review.
I am not the butler. I'm the maid.
I hired a butler.
And you've got...
Albert, I will count to three and then I will break down this door. For the last time, will you come out?
I've been out for years. Where have you been? These hands have been drenched in flour for the last time. I shall never cook again.
The great Zaza, you will be the ruination of me and this club with your lateness. Now hurry and get dressed.
Where were you this afternoon?
What's the difference? Get dressed.
I need a magnificent lunch. He said he'd be home. He wasn't.
Might as well talk to his mother.
I deboned a chicken. I stuffed her with pistachios and wild rice. Topped her off with truffles. And where was he? In absentia.
There are 500 paying customers waiting to see the great Zaza, and he stands here reciting the lunch menu.
Oh, it's not the chicken, George. It's the thought behind the chicken.
The what?
The thought behind the chicken.
Don't you have something better to do?
Many things.
Then do them.
Yell at my maid.
She's not your maid. She's your butler.
Now, I ask you.
I am going mad.
All right, George. My ankle bracelets, s'il vous plaît.
You could put them on yourself if you didn't wear that iron lung of a corset.
Ah! And so we have it. The cat is out of her bagage. You used to love putting on my ankle bracelets.
I didn't used to have to.
Feeling trapped, my love? Is that what the last 20 years together adds up to? Where once there knelt a prisoner of love, now crouches a caged creature longing to be free.
Oh, we're in fine form tonight. Brava, Zaza.
Oh, it's all painfully clear. First you stop missing meals, then my ankle bracelets, then separate bedrooms.
Oh, she's been rereading Colette.
And then the final blow. Some young, thin brunette draped across white chairs, puffing pot, piping pills, rotting his brains out with rock and roll.
Not Colette, Jackie Collins. Albert, would you believe me if I told you there was no one else?
No. Pity me, betray me, but don't lie to me, George. Not after all these years.
I swear it, there is no one else.
Are you coming, Zaza? Mercedes is on her last verse.
What?
For the fourth time!
Apparently so am I. Jacob, pack my gowns! We leave at sunrise!
Then please, the show!
The show, the show, the show! The show will go on, George. And so shall I. Alone, forsaken, abandonada, like a dog on a rock.
Like a what on a what?
Like a dog on a rock.
Alban, you know there is no one else, don't you? And you know there never has been, don't you? All right, then get dressed.
Please. Back on stage, and our band eats alone. Once again,
I'm a little depressed by the tired old face that I see. Once again, it is time to be someone who's anyone other than me. With a rare combination of girlish excitement and manly restraint, I position my precious assortment of powders and pencils and paint. So whenever I feel that my place in the world is beginning to crash, I apply one great stroke of mascara to my rather limp upper lash, and I can cope again. Good God, there's hope again. When life is a real bitch again, and my old sense of humor has up and gone, it's time for the big switch again. This perpetual marathon, I put down the John seat again, and put a little more mascara on, and everything sparkle dust, bugle beads, ostrich plumes, when it's a beaded lash that you look through. 'Cause when I feel glamorous, elegant, beautiful, the world that I'm looking at, beautiful too. When my little rope has a few bumps again, and I need something level to lean upon, I put on my sling pumps again. Ugly duckling is a swan. For when my spirits start to sag, I hustle out my highest drag and put a little more mascara on. And everything's ankle straps, marabou, shalimar. Woo! It's worth sucking in my gut and girdling my rear. Everything's ravishing, sensual, fabulous, when Alban is tucked away and Zaza is here. When everything slides down the old tubes again, and when my self-esteem has begun to drift, woo, I strap on my face. It's bleak, I simply rouge the other cheek, for I can face another day in slipper satin lingerie to make depression disappear. I screw some rhinestones on my ears and put my brooches and tiara and a little more mascara.
Sweet and Blue!
fool. She's my nephew. With hair like mine, you can do anything. Yes, you can! Suivez moi! And everything's ankle straps, Liverpool, Shalimar. It's worth sucking in my gut and girdling my rear. Cause everything's ravishing, sensual, fabulous. When Alban is tucked away and Zazai is here. When everything slides down the old tubes again. And when my self-esteem has begun to drift, you're going to be drifting in the Mediterranean, bitch, you do that again.
Only 7 minutes late, not bad for the first show.
No matter how old Zaza may be, she's still got style.
I know how old she is, and the only thing she's still got is nerve.
Cheap, Mercedes, cheap.
Oh, now, George, you know Zaza can't dance.
With a voice like that, she doesn't have to dance.
With a dress like that, she doesn't have to sing.
Attention, I have just received a supply of fuchsia pheasant feathers.
It's funny, Phaedra, how you can work with someone for years and years and never really get to know her.
Oh, Derma, Derma, Derma. Does anyone ever really know anyone? Ever? Really? At all? Ever?
At least they're not on drugs. You are the butler.
The maid. We agree.
Jacob.
Claudine. Or you won't get your surprise.
Right, I love surprises. What surprise, Jacob?
Who?
Oh, Claudine.
Now, you know how you're always asking folks down at the club to open your eyes. Mm-hmm. Well, Claudine's telling
me
to close your eyes. Round and around and around and around. Voila!
Oh, my life, my love, my heaven!
My!
Oh, I've missed you. Oh,
I've missed you too.
Isn't it wonderful? Our son's home!
Our son? Papa, please, I just walked in the door. I must say I like the outfit, Claudine, but what is it you're dressed for?
Dressed to serve your every need. This is for me, that for you, and this for your papa!
Papa always gets the best part.
Don't you dare laugh. You'll only encourage him.
He just behaves that way because he loves you.
If he loved me, he'd vacuum. Look at this place. It's disgusting.
God, it's good to be home.
Oh, it is so great to have you home. Now, I know you've only been away on holiday for a few weeks, but to this old man's heart, it seemed forever.
I won't be here long. Papa, I'm getting married.
See, this is what I love best about you. No hemming, no hawing. You have something to say, you say it clearly, precisely, right to the point. Like a knife in the heart.
And I was worried you wouldn't take it well.
You were right!
You mean you're not pleased for
it? I don't know, maybe I'm working up to it. Who is it that you're marrying? Not that Angelique.
Her name is Anne, Papa.
Don't change the subject. Jean-Michel, you go away on holiday with this Antoinette. The next thing I know, you're getting married. You are 20 years old. There's plenty of time for other women besides this Anisette.
Her name is Anne, and I'm 24.
Are you sure?
Sit down, Papa. I have a little problem.
24?
So do I. It's Anne's parents. Her father is Dandon. Edouard Dandon. Deputy General of the TFM.
You know me in politics. What's the TFM?
The Tradition, Family, and Morality Party.
I like the sound of that. There's a little bit of everything in there.
But it isn't terribly compatible with La Cage aux Folles.
And a deputy in the family. Not bad. We could use a little political clout these days. What with that idiot who's running for office? You know the one I mean. One who's pledged to close down all the transvestite clubs if elected.
His name is Dandon.
Edouard Dandon. Deputy General of the TFM.
And he's on his way here to meet you.
You're insane.
He, his wife, and Anne will be staying overnight.
Probably certifiable.
They'll be here for cocktails tomorrow.
Definitely dangerous. I
don't smoke? Well, Anne is nothing like her father, so there's nothing to worry about.
Except her father?
Well, we better get to work. We should start toning this place down a little, you know? Ditch a few of the more obvious ironies in the decor.
Well, you're ditching ironies. What's to become of me?
I took the liberty of telling them that you were with the French Foreign Service. Retired, of course. Don't worry, I was very vague.
If you can't be truthful, be vague.
They'll use the house entrance, and we'll close off this door to the club.
And who will our band be? French attaché to Finocchio's?
Well, anything he'd like, as long as he isn't here. Papa, you know the way he is. The way he talks and moves and dresses. You know.
So it's farewell to our band, just like that. The man raises you like a mother for the past 20 years, and you turn around and say, I'm engaged to the daughter of a fanatic, so this for me, that for you, and Papa always gets the best part. Judas!
Papa!
Traitor!
Papa, please!
Collaborationist?
Well, from your point of view, maybe. But, Papa, there's no one like Anne.
Nonsense. You've been in love a dozen times before.
Not like this.
What about Helene? Paulette?
No one. Never like this.
She's a witch.
Yes. She is.
Girls have come and gone, Papa. Angelique and Antoinette. Who did I prefer, Leslie or Helene? It was all a blur, and yet, Papa, when Anne comes running down the street, and I link my arm in hers, girls have come and gone, girls may come and go, yet something very odd occurs, Papa. Cause life is in perfect order with Anne on my arm. It makes my shoulders broader with Anne on my arm. Even when things won't gel and the pieces won't fit, I'm suddenly in, I'm suddenly on, I'm suddenly it. Who else and make me feel like I'm handsome and tall? Who else can make me feel I'm on top of it all? I found a combination that works like a charm. I'm simply a man who walks on the stars whenever it's Anne on my arm. A celebration with you on my arm. Walking's a new sensation with you on my arm. Each time I face a morning that's boring and bland, with you it looks good, with you it looks great, with you it looks grand. Somehow you've put a permanent star in my eye. Even the dead of winter can feel like July. We start a conflagration that's cause for alarm. We're giving off sparks and setting off bells whenever it's you. And make me feel like I'm handsome and tall. Who else can make me feel I'm on top of it all? I found a combination that works like a charm.
I'm simply a man who walks on the stars whenever it's out on my arm.
You make a most convincing case.
One more little thing.
I beg you, no more little things.
The Dandongs are coming to meet my parents.
So you've said.
I'd like you to invite Mother.
Mother who?
Mother Sybil, my mother.
You haven't seen Sybil in 20 years. Why would you want to invite her?
Well, I don't, but the Dandongs are coming to meet my parents.
So?
So I need a mother, and she's my mother.
So?
So will you call and ask her to come?
What we do with Alban if she comes? Put him in a hotel?
I love you.
You had better. But who tells Alban?
Wedding bells? Do I hear wedding bells?
Jacob strikes again.
What have we raised, George? An animal? Snakes live male and female together. Cats live male and female together. We are human beings. We know better. What would you talk about?
What do we talk about?
I love her, Alban.
Then why didn't you tell me yourself? Why must I hear about my own son from someone on the street? Look at you! You were so thin, you haven't been eating. It's that girl.
It's not the girl.
Her name is Anne.
You always tell me I'm too thin.
And that's because you always are. Now you march yourself right off to the kitchen and have Claudine give you some good hot soup.
Alban.
I'll talk to him.
Alban, I'm sorry.
He's sorry. He's sorry. Oh, George. Our baby is getting married. Where did we go wrong?
No, my love. We've lived through worse in our time. We'll get through this. We have an hour before the second show. What say we go for a little stroll?
Oh, I couldn't possibly take one tiny little step.
With me, you could.
Not in my condition.
Life is a celebration with you, Aunt. My aunt.
I'm too upset.
That's because you're not listening.
It's not either. I am listening.
Life is a celebration with you, Aunt. My aunt. It's worth the aggravation with you on my arm.
Well, he always did bounce back quicker than I.
That's because I'm more limber.
You always were. Woo!
Each time I face a morning that's boring and bland with you, it looks good.
I won't dance.
You won't. With you, it looks great.
Well, do I have
if
to?
You want me? With you, it looks grand.
Well, I'll force myself.
It's suddenly
whatever it's you.
Let's hire you.
nice to meet you, Hercule.
Jean-Michel is a cousin, Hercule.
You have a lot of cousins.
Don't worry, Hercule, I won't be in town long.
Family is family, Hercule. Give me 1 hour to ditch Hercule and pick me up at La Cage.
Paulette, I'm getting married.
Then make it a half an hour. Sorry, I'm late. How'd everything go with your parents?
Oh, they're thrilled for me. They can't wait to meet you. What about yours?
Oh, my mother's happy. It's my father. He's so caught up with his politics, he doesn't even know that I drove over here.
Well, I'll work hard to make him like me.
Oh, I can't wait to meet your parents. You don't know how lucky you are to have a father like yours and a mother who's so elegant and chic.
What say we take a walk on the beach?
Oh, but the beach is that way.
No, Anne, it's this way.
Jean-Michel!
It's starting to rain. I just heard thunder.
The sky couldn't be clearer.
It's starting to rain. Anne, if you love me, you'll believe me. It's starting to rain.
Ah, and so it is.
Feeling any better?
Oh, I suppose. But everything seems so dark and dim.
It's midnight, my love, and you're wearing sunglasses.
Bonsoir, monsieur. The fish are running well.
What is your call to be by in the morning?
Oh, merci.
Au revoir.
Au revoir. Au revoir. Oh, George, we're losing our baby.
It was bound to happen sooner or later.
Bonsoir, Etienne.
Bonsoir.
Colette.
The show tonight.
Ça va.
And how is your baby?
Well, I don't have a home in the countryside yet, but I am surviving.
Aren't we all, n'est-ce?
Oh, it seems like only yesterday that Jean-Michel bounced upon his maman's knee.
Speaking of mamans, there's
some... Cher Georges, cher Albert.
Cher Jacqueline.
I have just sent a very distinguished party straight from my restaurant to your little club. Midnight show, table down front.
Of course.
Problem, Sherry?
No problem. I will send your people champagne.
Merci.
And I'll send them a rose.
Mieux froid.
Bienvenue, mes chers amis.
Unusual.
Voilà.
And how are the children?
Getting bigger.
Growing older.
Aren't we all?
Growing older each year,
but we're surviving.
Aren't we all, Nespar?
While we're on the subject.
What subject?
Mothers. You know that Anne's parents are coming to meet Jean-Michel's family, and I thought it might be nice if he had his mother there with him.
Well, of course I'll be there. Georges, where else would I be?
Not you, Albin, Sybil.
Sybil, who?
Sybil, Jean-Michel's mother.
Oh, by Sybil, Jean-Michel's mother. Do you refer to that woman who seduced you one night backstage at the Lido in Paris? That woman who every 3 or 4 years thinks to send her own flesh and blood a birthday card, always, I might add, on the wrong day?
That's the one.
I tell you this, without threats or tantrums, if that woman comes, you die.
If only it were that easy.
What right has that woman to butt into the boy's life now? Where was she all those years when he was growing up, when he really needed his mother? I'll tell you where. Huddled in any corner of the world, in any corner of the room, with any kind of man she could lay her hands on. That's where she was. When I think of the times that he wrote her, called her, begged to see her. And always the same reply. Sorry, darling, I'm too busy.
Oh, nonetheless, she is his mother. She did carry him a certain amount of time.
Well, I would have delivered him sooner. And not to your doorstep.
Nevertheless, I've called her and she's coming.
And what else, George? I know by your face when something is bothering you. You might as well give me the bad news at once. Who else have you invited to this soiree?
It's not the invited that worries me. Excusez-moi.
Tonight, of all nights, there has to be a full moon.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
You had to wear that cologne.
But don't you like it?
Like it? And on top, you had to wear that particular blue.
But it's your favorite shade.
I know. Oh, Albert.
Oh, George, please. We're in public view.
I must be insane. To think that after 20 years, you could still bring a blush to my cheek.
You old fool.
Do you recall that windy little beach we walked along? That afternoon in fall, that afternoon we met a fellow with a concertina sang. What was the song? It's strange what we recall and odd what we forget. I heard la da 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 as we walked on the sand. I heard la da da da. I believe it was early September. Through the crash of the waves, I could tell that the words were romantic. Something about sharing, something about always. Though the years race along, I still think of our song on the sand. And I still try and search for the words I can barely remember. Though the time tumbles by, there is one thing that I am forever certain of. I hear la da da da. I believe it was early September. Through the crash of the waves, I could tell that the words were romantic. Something about sharing, something about always. Though the years race along, I still think of our song on the sand. And I still try and search for the words I can barely remember. Though the time tumbles by, there is one thing that I am forever certain of. I hear la da 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 da.
Play my heart like a concertina. You're such a poet. I'm not so sure about the crash of the waves, this being the Mediterranean. But basically, you are correct. This is all about love, this wedding, not jealousies or old wounds. So, Sybil can come. And the three of us shall bear witness to our son's marriage together. Hand in hand in hand.
Alban, there is something else that you should know.
Oh, sure. We shall be late for the second show.
Alban, I must tell you something.
No, shall we? I mustn't keep my audience waiting.
Tonight, for the first time in his life, he has to be on time. Oh, Alban, you are still a surprise. I hear la da 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 da.
sister.
I can't perform with any dust.
All right, everybody, pay up.
Pardonnez-moi.
Jean-Michel's engagement present.
Giving him?
Are we throwing him a shower?
You don't throw boys showers.
You threw me a shower?
Yes, well, I rest my case.
How about a stag party?
Well, we could bake an enormous cake.
And I could come out of it.
Majin, you are out of it. Now don't cry. We'll show blue movies.
And he rat-a-tat-tooey?
Rat-a-tat-tooey? Oh.
Rat-a-tat-tooey! Rat-a-tat-tooey!
Rat-a-tat-tooey! Rat-a-tat-tooey! Hi, here are my lovelies, all happy, laughing, chattering the night away while my business goes down the drain pipes.
Oh, George, leave them to me.
All right, ladies. Move it, or lose it.
Practicing, huh?
No. Making perfect.
What's been happening to you?
I'm dating Hannah.
I've got a van outside to put it all in.
Put all what in?
All the things from the apartment.
Jean-Michel, you're back.
Hello, Angelique.
He's getting married.
Oh, congratulations. Call me after the honeymoon.
Are you planning on moving something?
Just the statues, the paintings, the furniture?
Furniture?
Maybe we should start with Albin's closet.
What's wrong with Albin's closet?
Hi, Jean-Michel.
Hello, Nikki.
Surely these people are not going to make searches of our closet.
But where will I put Mother's clothes?
Put them anywhere you like, except our room.
But how will it look if she doesn't sleep in your room?
Like any couple married 20 years.
Would anyone around here like to do a show?
Call places. I'll get Zaza.
Oh, Papa, I'd like to settle this now before...
It's my Zaza. Vision in bugle beads. You take my breath away.
Thank you, George. Oh, Jean-Michel, I thought that after the show tonight, you, your father, and I might have a little supper together and discuss your wedding plans. Now, wouldn't that be nice?
Oh, terrific!
I'll be in the apartment when you're ready. We're starting on your room.
Starting what on my room?
Nothing, my pet.
Just a little spring cleaning.
Well, haven't you told him?
It was supposed to be a surprise, don't you remember?
Papa.
But why do spring cleaning when it isn't spring?
And it will be soon, with any luck.
I've got an orchestra, a song to sing, a chorus of lovely oddities.
Yes, and send that one back to Swan Lake.
Now all I need is a song.
Fear not, dear sweet St. Francis. Your star is on the rise. Jacob, my boa. Maestro, my music. Mes enfants. Suivez-moi!
I'm sorry, I thought you told him.
You have a lesson to learn in your young life. Discretion is the better part of marriage.
Well, come on, let's go. There's lots to do.
Just one moment. Come here.
Come here.
I want you to look at him and consider what it is you're asking me to do.
Look at him.
The man who has dedicated the last 20 years of his life to making a home for us. Who has lived almost exclusively for our comfort, yours and mine. I want you to look at him. Consider what it is you're doing. You are throwing him out of the home he has made for us.
For one night. Please. I'm only doing what's necessary.
Midnight! It makes you even more attractive. You know why you're here, and so do I. Welcome to our second show. What legend has told and rumor has promised, we will do our utmost to deliver. And now the moment you have all long awaited, Le Cachepot proudly presents the
greatest star on the Riviera, the one, the only, Zaza!
Bonsoir, bonsoir, good evening, and welcome to our modest little show. For those of you who have wandered in from the streets unbeknownst, hello, boys, and hello, girls, and hello, boy girls, and hello, girl boys. Is that everybody? They keep them in a pit, and for a good reason. Maestro, you look so debonair tonight, darling, in your simple little black suit. Don't worry, darling, we'll get you back to the convent in time. I hear we have a new trumpeter with us this evening. Bonsoir, mon petit chou. Does your mother know what your lips are doing tonight? Keep them on the trumpet, honey. Keep them on the trumpet. Oh, and how is our lady of the drums this evening? Hello, Kelly.
Hello, Zaza.
Ooh, Kelly, do you have a cold tonight? Mercy, mercy. We are an equal opportunity employer here at La Cage aux Folles. It's not a female impersonator. It's just a woman with a very deep voice. Are you ready? Well, that girl's got rhythm. And this, as if you couldn't guess from our tastefully decorated little sign out front, is La Cage aux Folles. We live life here in La Cage. How shall I put it? On an angle. Not to worry. You'll soon get your bearings. Just sit back. Take a deep breath. A sip of champagne. Open your eyes. What do you see? It's rather gaudy, but it's also rather grand. And while the waiter pads your check, he'll kiss your hand. The clever gigolos romance the wealthy matrons at Le Cage aux Folles. It's slightly 40s and a little bit new wave. You may be dancing with a girl who needs a shave. Where both the riffraff and the royalty are patrons at La Cage aux Folles. La Cage aux Folles. The maitre d' is dashing. Cage aux Folles. The hat check girl is flashing. Woohoo! We import the drinks that you buy. So your Perrier is Canada Dry. Eccentric couples always punctuate the scene. Woo! A pair of eunuchs and a nun with a marine. To feel alive, you get a limousine to drive you to La Cage aux Folles. Here tonight at La Cage aux Folles, the American stars of yesteryear are alive and well. Meet Mae West. Oh, yeah. Oh. I'm so glad you came up to see me here tonight at La Cage. Oh, 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 full. Is that a cello between your legs, honey? Or are you just glad to see me? Oh, hello, honey. I didn't recognize you. Sitting up. Hello, tall, dark, and handsome. Remind me of a cowboy I used to know in Texas. Oh, yeah. I used to have a cattle ranch in Texas. Yeah. But I had to sell it. I couldn't keep my calves together.
it's bad and beautiful. Oh, it's body and bizarre. I know a duchess, honey, she got pregnant at the bar. For who is who and what is what is quite the question at La Casual. Hello, darlings. It's Tallulah Bankhead. Am I the only one here tonight old enough to remember me? Here we are, darlings, on the beach of Saint-Tropez. Hey. My God, I thought it was the beach of San Gregorio. All those naked young men out there sunning themselves. If you're toasting that for me, darlings, I'll take it rare. Ah! Go for the mystery, the magic and the mood. And whatever you do, darlings, avoid the hustlers and the men's room and the food. For you get glamour and romance and indigestion at La Casual. Tradition, casual. You'll lose each inhibition all week long. We're wondering who left that creature for chicken in the loo. What a dump. It's Marwena Dietrich. Do you remember me from the war? I remember you in that foxhole. Falling in love again, never wanted to. Do you like my wigs? There's only one way better looking than this way, and it's this way. You go alone to have the evening of your life. You'll meet your mistress and your boyfriend and your wife. It's a bonanza, it's a mad extravaganza at La Casual. You cross the threshold and your bridges have been burned. The bar is cheering, for the Duchess has returned. The mood's contagious, you know, bring your whole outrageous entourage. It's hot and hectic, and the best is dandy, clanking at La Casual. La Casual.
Sweet and wild!
just something else. My, 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 my.
You ever seen legs go up higher, faster in your life? I bet you have. I'm sorry it took me so long, darlings, but I wanted to slip into something a little more comfortable. Do you like it?
Takes a man to wear a dress like this.
Oh! That Marlene Dietrich was so naughty to you! Talking about her legs and not showing them to you. Zaza talks, she delivers. You can applaud, you paid for your seats. You didn't pay that much. Well, if you can't hide it, decorate it.
You'll be so dazzled by the ambiance you're in. You'll never notice that there's water in the gin. Come have a drink and you will want to spend the winter at Le Cajo Fro. Le Cajo Fro, a Saint-Tropez tradition. Cajo Fro, you'll lose each inhibition. We indulge each change in your mood. Come and sip your Dubonnet in the nude. La la la. La 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 la.
You go alone to have the evening of your life. You'll meet your mistress and your boyfriend and your wife. It's a bonanza, it's a mad extravaganza at Le Cajo Fro. You cross the threshold and your bridges have been burned. The bar is cheering for the Duchess has returned. The mood's contagious, you can bring your whole outrageous entourage. Entourage! It's hot and hectic, effervescent and eclectic at Le Cajo.
Gentlemen, the management of Le Cajo Fro has searched the globe to bring you the fiercest in entertainment. From the deepest corner of your darkest fantasy, the eternal struggle of man versus beast, the mortal battle of beauty and leather, Hanna from Hamburg!
Halcyon! Spring cleaning is one thing, but where are you going with my gown?
Just finish changing, I'll explain it all later.
Explanations are being entertained now, s'il vous plaît.
Would you tell him already?
2 minutes, Zaza!
Go change, everything's fine.
Everything is not fine.
Keep it down, ladies, there's an artist at work here.
I'm waiting, George.
Papa, please tell him.
All right.
Alban, I shall explain it all, and I'm certain if I tell you, we can discuss this calmly and quietly like two mature adults.
It's that bad, huh?
No, not really. Let me explain. You know that Ant's parents are coming, and I've told you that Sybil is coming. What I failed to tell you is that you're not. Do you know that politician who's trying to impose his morality on the coast? Well, he's the girl's father. So, what can you do? You can't choose your parents. And Jean-Michel assures me that Anne is nothing like her father, so we should be thankful for small favors. Anyway, they are who they are, and they're on their way here. And so for one night, I will be someone else for them. And for one night, Sybil will be my wife. And after they're gone, we'll all have a good laugh about how we pulled one over on them. Well, when you think of it, it really is very funny. I mean, me, a diplomat in the French Foreign Service. Sybil, my wife. You. This is one of those stories that we'll laugh about for the rest of our lives. So, what do you say?
I'm sorry, Alban. I have a show to finish.
We love how it feels, putting our heels, causing confusion. We face life, though it's sometimes sweet and sometimes bitter. Face
with life, with a little of
God. No!
No!
Get off. Please. Give me the hook or the ovation. It's my world that I want to have a little pride in. My world, and it's not a place I have to hide in. Life's not worth a damn till you can say, hey world, I am what I am. I am what I am. I don't want praise, I don't want pity. I bang my own drum, some think it's noise, I think it's pretty. I love each feather and each spangle. Why not try to see things from a different angle? Your life is a sham till you can shout how proud I am what I am. I am what I am, and what I am needs no excuses. I deal my own death, sometimes the ace, sometimes the
Le Cage.
Oh, I don't believe a word of it.
Bonjour, Etienne. Bonjour. people are such scandal mongers.
Aren't we all Nespa?
I must speak with you.
Please keep your distance. Have you no respect for a homeless widow?
I searched all night for you.
You make me laugh.
Where did you sleep? Have you eaten? You look tired.
No need to worry about us, for the gods protect their children. Oh, Jason.
Listen, Medea. I've got 50 francs that says you have someplace else to be.
Do you really think my loyalty can be purchased with a mere 50 francs?
I'll make it 100.
You got a deal.
Done.
I take my leave, mistress. But fear not, for the gods are with you.
Ben, my love,
I have nothing to say to you, George.
I'm sorry, all right?
I'm sorry. It's not all right. To think that I would live to see the day when Jean-Michel, who I raised as my own, would cast me out.
He's a kid. He wasn't thinking. He's in love.
And you?
I'm an old fool who also wasn't thinking, who's also in love.
How much did you pay him?
Flash of the waves, I could tell that the words were romantic. Something about sharing,
something about always.
Though the years race along, I still think of our song on the sand. And I still try and search for the I can barely remember. Though the time tumbles by, there is one thing that I am forever certain of. I hear la da da da.
I am still unwanted.
Albert, you are wanted. It's all you bring with you that's questionable. You have certain mannerisms, albeit charming mannerisms, that could shock people who haven't been forewarned.
A two? That could shock people who haven't been forewarned.
My mannerisms can translate as tasteful affectation, while yours are no less than suspicious.
No less than suspicious.
Bonjour.
Bonjour. Bonjour.
Breakfast?
No.
Yes.
I'm not hungry.
I am.
Pig.
Albert, the point is, you may attend this affair tonight if you choose, simply by donning the proper attire and appropriately straightening up your act. You shall assume the role of Jean-Michel's dear Uncle Al.
Uncle Al?
What's wrong with that?
Well, the displacement in stature, for one thing. Even if you had a wife who wasn't a drunk, you wouldn't pass her off as the maid.
But a drunken wife is at least a woman, and in the mind of the masses, a lush is more presentable than a fruit.
Suddenly, you're no fruit? Just because you had a baby one night by accident?
It was no accident.
You told me it was an accident!
It was absolutely no accident. Sybil was the most beautiful showgirl at the Lido.
Sybil's a pig.
I shall ignore that remark. She was the most beautiful showgirl at the Lido, and I, playing a Greek god, was pound for pound her match. The opportunity presented herself, and I said to myself, everyone always talks so much about it, I might as well see what the fuss is all about. And it was a beautiful and moving experience.
As if you could remember, as drunk as you were.
It lasted from midnight till 2:45. Just how drunk could I have been?
Oh, that's right. Just slap me in the face with your infidelities, animal.
Albert, are you coming tonight or not?
As Uncle Al.
As Uncle Al.
please.
Don't do that.
All right, I will come tonight, but only because the boy needs me, whether he knows it or not. Besides, without me there, you're bound to screw it up.
Thank you, my love. Now, to prepare. Slouch.
Slouch?
Yes, slouch. Not like that. You better slouch in this chair over here. He's going to be a heterosexual man tonight. He better behave like one. Slouch!
What's the matter? Well, you yelled at me. Sorry, he yelled at me.
Yes, I yelled at you, but you're a man. You must face up to your destiny. You must say to yourself, something terrible has happened. I have been yelled upon. But I am a man. I am strong. I will climb back up that mountain!
Bravo, Joe!
Drop your shoulders. Let them go all round and beaten. Don't hold in your stomach. Let it pour over your lap as a testimonial to those nights spent drinking with the boys. Let it pour over your lap. Now, spread your legs.
Excusez-moi.
You're going to be wearing pants tonight, not a skirt. Spread them. You can do better than that. Spread them. Spread them! Now, pick up that croissant. Try the toast. No, not like that. Like a man. Think of, John Wayne.
Exactly, John Wayne.
I want you to pick up that piece of toast like John Wayne. I thought I said John Wayne.
Well, it is John Wayne. It's a little girl.
Let's begin again. Think of this as masculine toast and masculine butter. Ready for spreading by a masculine hand. Pick up that knife and make believe it's a machete. It'll take all your strength and steady nerves for hacking your way through the cherry preserves. Think of John Wayne and Jean-Paul Belmondo. Think of the Legionnaires and Charlemagne's men. And like a Steve O'Toole, you grab your cup. And if God forbid that your pinky pops up, you can climb back up the mountain once again.
Have you got that?
I think so.
No. Don't think so. You're a man.
I'm a man.
You're a man.
I'm a man.
You're a man.
I said I was a man.
Oh, well, Ben.
About that voice of yours. Grunt like an ape and growl like a tiger. Give us a roaring, snoring, masculine laugh. Try to remember that John Wayne was not soprano. Try making it rough and rough and low. No. Try more of John Wayne and less Brigitte Bardot. Think of De Gaulle and think of Rasputin.
Think like a dad, you're marching into the den.
While trying to join the burly brutes, if you forget that your nylons are under your boots, you can climb back up the mountain once again.
Oh, Francis, walk for us. You see how he holds himself? His head held straight and high.
Well, that's easy for him. He's wearing a neck brace. I'm not even going to try that.
You don't have to try it. Just feel it, right?
Right.
Now, here, try to imitate this walk.
I'm thrilled.
Has Mother arrived yet?
Mother who? Lord, do you see a mother around here?
Don't you think that outfit smacks a bit of overkill?
No more than you're decorating.
You think I went too far?
When it comes to going too far. You asking the wrong person.
You'd better behave tonight. We made a deal.
And so we did. And I shall perform to the full perfection of my butler best. And you'll get your father to put me in the show, right?
Just the finale, and for one night only.
That's all I need. And there'll be magic in that theater the night those silver curtains part. And there, in the midst of lavender incense, a pure white light reveals this ebony goddess I was born to shine! Just give me a break, mister. That's all I'm asking. Just give me a break!
You give me a break.
Oh.
Well, Mother Teresa's decorator has arrived.
I suppose a gray suit will do. You are supposed to be retired.
That's meant to be a compliment. I can do without it.
No, you look very handsome.
Yes, I do, don't I?
Yes, very.
Wait till you see Alban.
Alban?
Yes, Alban!
It is nice to be on the offensive side of the shock. Yes, Alban. We have been rehearsing all afternoon. Tonight will be his greatest challenge. Tonight. The greatest challenge in his long and illustrious theatrical career. Tonight, the great Zaza as Uncle Albert.
Oh, God save us all.
Come show your sweet nephew the Frankenstein his love has wrought. Voila! A man to be reckoned with. Your Uncle Albert.
Come. Huh?
You're doing beautifully. Lovely. Dashing. You'll be turning heads on the Champs-Élysées. Girls' heads.
Bonjour, monsieur. It is indeed a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
Oh, Papa, look! The crown jewel!
Oh, please allow me some comfort.
No, Alban, the boy is right.
Help! Someone get me out of here!
Coming, dear sweet saint.
I thought you locked that door.
I did. Francis has a key.
Sorry, a telegram arrived.
What's that? What happened?
I'm engaged to Hannah.
Ah!
Congratulations!
What is it?
I did nothing. It's from a fan.
This is never going to work. Crazy people coming in and out. Mother's late.
Pull yourself together. It'll be fine.
It's going to be a disaster.
Not if you keep your wits about you.
Papa, I love Anne, and I'm going to lose her.
I'll let you in on a secret, my little one. If she loves you, you won't lose her, no matter what happens here.
I should have known better. I asked for one lousy favor from him, and look, I should have known better. My whole life I had to put up with his nonsense. When I think of what I had to go through because of him, the razzings I took at school, the beatings I got defending him, people staring as we'd walk down the street because he'd insist we'd stroll arm in arm. I'd ask for a shirt, he'd buy me a blouse.
What about what he's given up for you? The vacations, the holidays, the hours he spent on your homework, the nights he sat up in your sick room. Did you ever want for anything? Private schools? Cars? Cash? Clothes? Did you ever ask for anything you did not get?
Yes. A little respect for what I want. A little understanding.
A little respect. A little understanding.
How often is someone concerned with the tiniest thread of your life? Concerned with whatever you feel and whatever you touch? Look over there. Look over there. Somebody cares. Does somebody sense that you need them without being told? When you have a hurt in your heart, you're too proud to disclose. Look over there. Look over there. Somebody always knows. When your world spins too fast, your bubble has burst. Someone puts himself last so that you can come first. So count all the loves who will love you from now till the end of your life. And when you have added the loves who have loved you before, look over there. Himself last so that you can come first. So count all the loves who will love you from now to the end of your life. And when you have added the loves who have loved you before, look over there.
Jean-Michel.
Poor Jean-Michel?
Oh, it's from Sybil. Dearest family, stop. The Duke proposed to stop. Going to Amsterdam for a red light district wedding. Stop. Sorry, Mother Sybil.
Damn that woman.
She's done it to him again.
Well, I will simply tell the Dandos that one of our relatives took ill and that Sybil went to nursing.
And what do we tell the boy?
The truth, no.
Oh, George, he will be so disappointed. No, Mother. Oh!
All right, you three. Listen carefully. For the next 24 hours, there will be people here of a lifestyle not at all like yours. I beg you, for the next 24 hours, to dispense with everything that brings you personal joy and everything you personally take pride in. My future depends on it.
Well, I was raised a Christian. Humiliation is my lot.
All right. Now, Papa, I will greet them. You stand over there. And now, Van, please, back there somewhere. All right. Everyone ready? On your marks? Get set! Go!
Excellency, the Deputy Dan Dawn. Madame Dan Dawn. And the Mademoiselle in question.
Charming child. Welcome to my home.
Thank you.
Anne!
May I present my father?
A pleasure.
A pleasure.
A pleasure.
My pleasure.
Jacob, fetch the luggage.
Quite a surprise. It's impressive.
Yes, that's the word, impressive. I like marble, albeit pink marble, but it's simple. I like simplicity. I hardly expected to find this almost monk-like atmosphere in a district notorious for its pleasure palaces.
Take some getting used to.
Yes, it certainly does.
Especially with that nightclub next door.
Marie, please. That is a nightclub next door?
Oh, I really wouldn't know. It does appear so.
What sort of club is it?
I really wouldn't know. We don't associate with that sort of people.
What sort of people might they be?
No, I really wouldn't know. We don't go out in the nighttime. They don't come out in the day.
Frolic while they may. After my re-election, I'll sweep them clean.
And I'll be right behind you with a broomstick.
Oh, what a beautiful crucifix. It's an antique.
It's our father.
What?
No, I mean my father. My father found it in an archaeological dig. In a pyramid.
Would anyone care for champagne? No, thank you. I leave champagne to those who wish to impress. Myself, I stick to a working man's wine. I am, after all my successes, still just an old working man.
Bravo! And I, myself, am just an old foreign legionnaire.
No, you're in the French Foreign Service.
I joined the Foreign Legion with a saber in my hand. I crawled across the desert with my belly in the sand. With men who love their camels and their brandy, and I swear, nobody dished, nobody swished when I was a Foreign Legionnaire.
Would you like an order?
Let me help. Oh, how adorable these dishes are. Youngsters playing together.
They look like Greeks.
But they can't be Greeks, not on my plates. Unless they weren't washed well.
Well, young boys in any case.
No, there should be girls too. It's a mixed service.
Oh, what lovely dishes. They're so delicate and frail. My love naked children, I believe their own. The male, oh, I think they're playing some exotically to a game.
Oops, I think that leapfrog is its name.
My mother, the wife of my father, begs your forgiveness. She had to be at her sick godmother's bedside. She shouldn't be much longer.
How did you know that?
She phoned just a little while ago. Anyway, very sorry.
This is even worse than I feared. The son is strange, the father is weird. To meet the wife, I'm actually afraid. I prefer that and remain.
completely devoted.
My son knows how much I love him and to what extremes, but my wife, I love her like an anima.
More hors d'oeuvres.
It's appalling to confess. Our new in-laws are a mess. She's a prude, he's a prig, she's a pill, he's a pixel, Zeus. Zeus, Zeus for you, Papa.
I do beg your forgiveness, but my great-uncle was dying, and I just had to wait.
No need to apologize, but we understood it was your godmother.
Clever you! And so it was. It was my great-uncle who also served as my godmother since my godmother passed away. Ooh, God knows what I'll do for a godmother now.
Let alone a great-uncle.
May I present my mother, Madame.
Dear sir. Oh.
Oh. Oh.
Madame. And this must be the little mademoiselle. Come here, come here. May I kiss you?
Please.
Oh. I could be your mamma.
Something to put in your mouth, mamma.
Did you wash your hands before serving?
Mamma.
He's 20 years old, but he is still my little baby.
I'm 24.
My, how time flies. What's the matter, dear? You look a little pale.
Your husband seemed upset about your absence.
Oh, were you worried about me, mon chou?
I still am.
What a lovely dress. I just adore comfortable clothes. Believe it or not, before you arrived, I was lounging around in one of my husband's suits.
More food?
But George just hates me in his pants.
I do not hate you in my pants. More hors d'oeuvres.
I'm ordering for dinner.
Oh, please, dear Lord.
Boom! You'll be dining out. Out! I hope you don't mind if I take the liberty of making reservations for dinner.
I don't care much for commercial food.
Oh, I'm sure Monsieur Dandon will find something to please his palate at Chez Jacqueline.
Chez Jacqueline! Oh, Edouard, did you hear?
Marie, please!
Have you been there, madame?
Oh, I've been trying to get my husband to take me there for years. Chez Jacqueline!
Oh, I'm so pleased, you're pleased.
And they're booked up for months in advance. Now, just how will you get a reservation?
Oh, it's just a little mother's magic. First you find a telephone, lift the receiver, dial the number, and speak sweetly. Hello? Jacqueline, oui, I need you. How many will be... Six, sweet and wild! Are you coming, George?
Do you think I'm out of my mind?
I always hope so. To make room for my little party.
Well, for an old friend, always. And thank you for accommodating my little outing last night.
Shall we take our seats?
Oh, my George. So dashing, so glittering. You grow more handsome every day.
Jacqueline, please, my growing days are over.
Come, let me show you to your table.
I wonder how much she cheats on her taxes. Remind me to check up on her.
Voila! I will send your waiter to you at once. And perhaps after you've settled in, I can beg a little favor, yes?
No.
We'll see.
Happy mes enfants?
Oui, maman.
I must confess that when Anne announced her engagement, we were quite surprised.
Oh, I can imagine.
Oh, you should have seen the look on George's face when Jean-Michel told us he was marrying a woman. A white woman.
They are, after all, quite pale, these virgins.
Well, I suppose so.
Well, I can account for our son.
Well, Anne stands to inherit quite a dowry on her wedding day, that is, if we approve of the choice of her husband.
Attention, attention, messieurs, dames. As those of you who frequent our little establishment know, that we count many celebrities and heads of state among our treasured clientele. And I wouldn't think of disturbing their privacy by introducing them. But tonight, I cannot resist. For among you sits one of my favorite people on this earth. Someone who has created a unique place in the world. And from there brings happiness to us all.
Edouard, I think she's going to introduce you.
Marie, please, I have ears.
Monsieur Dan, lift your glass with me to toast. A unique individual, the one and only Zaza.
Oh, goodbye, wedding.
Zaza,
you an actress?
Oh, I'm retired now. It was just a fling, a hobby.
Yes, she tried growing zucchini, but singing seemed to suit her better.
After an introduction like that, I am certain that we can persuade Zaza to favor us with a little song.
No, 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 no. Thank you, Jacqueline, but I have retired from public life. I'm just a mother now.
A mother? You've been to Lourdes?
Well, I would love to hear you sing if anyone wants my vote.
No one else does.
Please, Zaza. Just one little chanson. I won't take no for an answer. I'll stand here and badger you all night.
Perhaps you'd better, Mother.
Jacqueline, chérie, you go too far.
The key of A?
Not anymore, chérie.
A flat now.
Merci, mieux pas.
I would like to sing this song tonight for someone very special. My husband, Georges. And dear Anne, who soon will be our daughter-in-law. Maestro?
A flat.
Fiddle play. This is a little song, nostalgic and unique. I learned to sing this song before I learned to speak. Upon my mother's knee, and she learned to sing a song upon her mother's knee, and her mother learned to sing a song upon her mother's knee, and her mother learned to sing a song upon her mother's knee, and her mother learned to sing a song upon her mother's knee. So, if your mother sang this little song to you, then sing along with me. The best of times is now. What's left of summer but a faded rose? The best of times is now. As for tomorrow, well, who knows? Who knows? Who knows? So hold this moment and live and love as hard as you know how, and make this moment last.
counts is now, is now, is now. Now, not some forgotten yesterday. Now, tomorrow is too far away. So hold this moment fast and live and love as hard as you know how, and make this moment last, because the best of times is now, is now, is now.
Because the best of times is
that a daughter of mine could get herself involved with filth like this.
Edward, please.
It's all your fault, Marie.
My fault?
Yes.
What say we forget about tonight and start fresh in the morning?
Homosexual.
I think we better wait out this round.
Pack us up and move us out of this house of sin, Edward. We'll be right behind you.
I'm sorry, Mother. We are not right behind. I'm staying here, and I'm going to marry Jean-Michel.
Then I'll cut you off without a sou. Oh,
cut me off? Do you really think I brought you here just to get a dowry?
You mean you knew about these people?
No, but now that I do, it doesn't matter. I like them.
Homosexuals!
Father, please don't bellow. They know what they are!
Young lady, you march yourself straight out that front door.
No. Father, I love you. You too. You're my family. But I love Jean-Michel. And we want to make a family of our own.
Your own? What sort of a family do you think the son of a pervert could make? Being brought up as he was by two transvestite homosexuals.
One transvestite?
One plain homosexual.
Deputy Dandon, I apologize for what happened tonight. I made a terrible mistake, and I'm going to spend the rest of my life trying to make up for it. I hope one day I'll receive forgiveness for being stupid and thoughtless.
I do not accept your apology.
It wasn't to you I was apologizing. It was to my parents.
Parents? Parents? What parents? Oh, one of them might possibly be your father, but I don't think the other one can be your mother.
That is precisely who he is.
I see no mother here.
I do.
How often is someone concerned with the tiniest thread of your life? Concerned with whatever you feel and whatever you touch? Look over there. From now to the end of my life. And when you have added the loves who have loved me before, look over there, look over there. Somebody loves you
Marie, they are all insane. Let's get out of here before they turn on us.
Monsieur forgets his things, no? This for you, that for me, and this for you, Papa.
Papa always gets the best part.
Let's get out of here.
Oh, there you are, Deputy Dandon. You all came in so quickly, I didn't realize who you were. Naughty, naughty, Zaza. You should have told me who he was.
Well, somehow I knew you'd figure it out.
And somehow I did. And once I knew, I said to myself, Jacqueline, I said, there goes the famous Deputy Dandon, leaving your establishment, and you didn't even get your picture taken with him. And then I said, Jacqueline, seeing as how he left in such a hurry, without even paying his bill. I am certain that he wouldn't mind my inviting the newspapers or the television stations for a casual photo session with his old friend, Jacqueline. And so here we are. The press awaits outside.
Newspapers?
Mm-hmm.
Television?
Uh-huh.
I'll be ruined!
But of course.
suppose, Jacqueline, you are such a star follower.
Well, no, Zaza. There is more to running a successful restaurant than good food. I always say a little publicity is worth more than a good sauce.
And having your picture taken next to the most famous anti-homosexual on the Riviera, alongside the most infamous homosexual on the Riviera.
That's what I call a good sauce.
Jacqueline! Deputy Ding Dong.
The name is Dandon.
Oh, be nice.
We think we can help you out of this most embarrassing situation.
You how?
Yes, my wife and I have been discussing the matter, and we have decided to give our blessings to the union of our children.
And we think that you should do the same, don't you?
Never!
Edward! Edward, please!
Is it true you're a homosexual?
How do you know so? Have my blessing.
And the matter of the dowry.
Yes, she can have her dowry.
And one other thing. On special occasions when you're invited for family gatherings, Christmas, birthdays, you'll do us a little favor.
We'll come.
Don't.
Deal.
Congratulations, mes enfants.
Thank you, Maman.
Thank you, Maman.
Thank you, Maman.
What about me?
Oh, Jacqueline, we forgot all about Jacqueline. Yes. No, we wouldn't want to do that now after all she's done for us, would we?
No!
Jacob, would you escort Jacqueline out to meet the photographers? Tell them we will all be out in a moment. Jacqueline, I trust you will be able to entertain the gentlemen while we change.
You can count on me.
We always do.
Vanguard.
Did you lock it?
I'm no fool.
I know. You're the maid.
Well, I hope you all are enjoying yourselves. Meanwhile, I'm still stuck right where I started. Blackmail to the right of me, betrayal to the left, ruination in front of me, and God knows what in the rear. Can't you please help me get out of here?
Well, there is a way.
There is?
Isn't it about time for the finale?
The finale?
The finale!
The finale!
Sweet name
law! And so, my friends, once again, the inevitable is upon us. To end our little show. Time for all the pieces that have flown apart to come together again. And if we have done our job correctly, you will leave here with more than a folded program and a ticket stub. Ladies and gentlemen, La Casa Hall proudly presents our finale, bringing our steaming starlets out of the depths for your delectation. And as an added extra special surprise, some of the newest, some of the brightest, some of the oddest talents to appear in the cabaret world. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? Maestro, if you please.
With you on my arm, walking's a new sensation. With you on my arm, each time I face a morning that's boring and bland. With you, it looks good. With you, it looks great. With you, it looks grand.
Mercedes, the magnificent.
You put a permanent star in my. Can feel like
Hanna from Hamburg.
I found a combination that works like a charm. It's all the
new. Woo!
Jacobina, temptress of the tropics, sugar and spice, and every vice. That track. Over there, over there, over there with your bad self. And now Ave Maria, a siren for every season, and a surprise for every sense. Over there, Proud Mary. Oh, thank you. And now, what family doesn't have one? Winhilda, a woman no one could possibly ignore. One look, and you can never forget her face. Hard as you try.
One thing that I am forever certain.